Dear viewers, welcome to today's presentation on securitization and reconstruction of financial assets and enforcement of Security Interest Act 2002. In short, that is SARFAESI Act 2002. This topic is very important and very useful for JIB, CIB, bank promotional exams preparations, and attending for banks interviews. The same topic may also be useful for CA final corporate allied loss paper and CMA final other corporate loss students preparation. The securitization and reconstruction of financial assets and enforcement of Security Interest Act 2002 formulated to regulate securitization and reconstruction of financial assets. Enforcement of the security interest in NPA accounts without intervention of the court. This is the important point in this section. Matters connected therewith or incidental thereto, they can deal with under SARFAESI 2002. What are the objectives of SARFAESI Act 2002? Efficient or rapid recovery of non-performing assets of the bank's financial institutions. Allows banks and financial institutions to auction properties without intervention of the court when borrower failed to repay their loans and the account turned to NPA. Loans not eligible under SARFAESI Act. Banks financial institutions are not eligible to go for SARFAESI action in the following cases. Loan outstanding not exceeding rupees 1 lakh. Any security interest created in agriculture land. It means agriculture securities are also not eligible. Loan secured by pledge, lien or by way of security of bank deposits. In the documentation, the limitation has expired as per Limitation Act. Where security is not charged to in favor of bank. The amount due is less than 20% of the principal and interest. It means 80% or more of principal interest already paid by the borrower in this account. Any rights of unpaid seller also. And creation of security in any vessel or aircraft. In all the cases, the loans are not eligible under SARFAESI Act initiation. SARFAESI Act is applicable to banks, financial institutions, debenture trustees appointed by banks or financial institutions or company for secured debt securities. So, this is the ARCs, asset reconstruction companies. And finally, non-banking financial companies with the asset size of 100 crores and above. And the minimum loan size eligible for debt recovery under this act is 20 lakhs and above. This is the budget changes of February 2021. So, these institutions are eligible to exercise the SARFAESI action for recovery of their dues. Secured creditor. Creditor or secured creditor, banker, must be a secured creditor, must have some security in the defaulted account. Hypothecation and SARSAI was also defined under SARFAESI Act. SARSAI abbreviation, Central Registry of Securitization, Asset Reconstruction and Security Interest of India. In the consortium accounts for exercising of securitization, at least creditors representing 60% of outstanding dues have to agree to proceed under Securitization Act. As per the decision of Supreme Court in Transcor versus Union of India and others, as regards SARFAESI action initiation and DRT proceedings, the case under SARFAESI can be proceeded with or without withdrawal of the DRT application. It means that banker financial institution can exercise simultaneously either SARFAESI action or DRT are under both. Then section 13, subsection 2, Securitization Act. Under 13, section 13, subsection 2, demand notice for payment of dues. The secured creditor has issued a demand notice on the borrower for repayment of dues. The period of the notice is 60 days. Show cause notice we are issuing. This notice was signed by authorized officer of the bank, not less than SIP manager. So that is called a demand notice. Against the demand notice, the borrower right to representation or objection by the customer or borrower for 13-2 notice, the secured creditor must reply within 15 days from the date of receipt of the objection from the borrower or party. This is under section 13, subsection 3. How a banker can financial institution can serve the notice to the borrower? Hand delivery, speed post, fax, courier, or any other means of transmission of documents like fax messages or electronic mail. If the notice is not delivered or returned undelivered, the secured creditor has to publish the notice into newspapers. Then section 13, subsection 4, Securitization Act, that is position notice. If the liability is not cleared within 60 days from the date of 13-2 demand notice, secured creditor can issue 30 days position notice by registered post to the borrower. Further, the secured creditor should publish the position notice within 7 days from the date of issue in 2 newspapers, and one is in vernacular local language. The secured creditor may take recourse to one or more of the following measures to recover his loans. Take possession of the secured assets, including the right to transfer by way of lease, assignment, or sale. The secured creditor can take over the management of the business of the default borrower, or the secured creditor can appoint any person to manage the secured assets. These are the measures available for the security creditor for recovery of the loan. Section 14, that is absence from the district magistrate or chief judicial magistrate. If the borrower does not permit to take possession of the secured asset, authorized officer of the bank can seek the absence of district magistrate or chief judicial magistrate under section 14. The chief judicial magistrate or district magistrate, after being satisfied with the contents of the affidavit filed by the authorized officer of the bank, shall pass an suitable orders for the purpose of taking the possession of the secured asset within a period of 30 days from the date of application filed by the authorized officer. Then section 15, this is most important. Manner and effect of takeover of management. When the management of the business is taken over, the secured creditor may, by publishing a notice in a newspaper in English and other in vernacular local language. On publication of notice in public newspaper, all persons holding office as directors or holding any office of power of superintendents shall be deemed to have vacated. Any contract of management between the borrower and any director or manager shall be deemed terminated. The directors or administrators appointed under this section shall take such steps to take control or custody of the secured property. The director appointed under this section shall, for all the purposes, be directors of the company. On realization of debt, under this, the secured creditor, banker, shall restore the management of the company of the business of the borrower to him. This is about section 15, manner and effect of takeover of management. Section 16, no compensation to directors for loss of office. Section 17, within 45 days from the date of receipt of the notice under section 13, subsection 4, portion notice, the borrower can prefer an appeal to the debt recovery tribunal under section 17 of the Act, seeking stay against the Securitization Act. DRT to dispose of the appeal within 60 days, maximum maybe within 4 months. Again, under section 18, the borrower can appeal to debt recovery appellate tribunal within 30 days of order made by the DRT against the securitization appeal. Borrower has to deposit 50% while appeal to DRAT, and DRAT has power to reduce the deposit amount not less than 25% of DRT order. Section 18C, right to lodge a caveat by the secured creditor. If any petition filed by any party with DRT, so that sumoto ex parte order cannot be passed by the DRT without issuing a notice to the caveater, that is a secured creditor. The validity of this caveat is 90 days. That is the benefit of filing caveat with DRT. Section 20A, integration of registration system with the central registry. Now, integration of registration system of the Motors Vehicles Act 1988 and integration of records in so far it relates to registration of vehicles shall be available under the integration of registration with the central registry. Section 26C, subsection 2 provides priority of registered charge. Where there is a registered security interest there, any subsequent security interest created against that security will be subordinate to a pre-registered interest with the SRSAI. 26D, section 26D provide that no secured creditor shall be entitled to exercise the right of enforcement of securities under SRSAI Act unless the secured interest has been registered with SRSAI. So once after giving the loan, the secured creditor had to register with SRSAI. Then section 26E, priority to secured creditors. That debts due to any secured creditor shall be paid in priority for all other debts and the revenues. So the secured creditor is having prior right than all other debts and all revenues, including taxes, cesses, and other rates payable to the government, central government and state government or local government. So it means that the secured creditor is having priority over all other debts. Then the security interest enforcement rules 2002. Rule 6, sub-rule 2, sale notice of mobile properties. At the time of mobile, you have to follow rule 6, sub-rule 2. Rule 8, sub-rule 6, sale notice for sale of immobile properties. The authorized officer of the bank or financial institution shall serve to the borrower a notice of 30 days for sale of the immobile secured assets. Then, rule 9, sub-rule 1, 30 days public notice of sale is published in a newspapers. On sale, the purchaser shall immediately pay a deposit of 25% of the sale price, and the remaining balance amount shall be paid by the purchaser on or before the 15th day of confirmation of sale of immobile property. Rule 11, procedure for recovery of shortfall of secured debt. Where dues of the secured creditors are not fully recovered from the sale of the secured asset, the secured creditor may file an application with the debt recovery tribunal pursuant to section 13, subsection 10 of the SRFAS Act 2002. Then, this is the summary of important sections and time norms under this Act. Demand notice, section 13, subsection 2, issued by and signed by authorized officer of the bank, that is a 60 days show cause notice to the borrower. Demand notice. Now, for the demand notice, party may raise objection to the bank. So bank has to give reply to objection raised by the borrower under section 13 subsection 3A within 15 days from the date of receipt of the objection. Then after completion of 60 days, clear 60 days, the secured creditor can issue possession notice under section 13 subsection 4, that is also 30 days notice. After issue of 30 possession notice, party is not cooperating or not giving handing over the portion of the property, the authorized officer can take the assistance by chief metropolitan magistrate or district magistrate in taking possession under section 14 of this act. That chief metropolitan magistrate, district magistrate have to take steps within 30 days for making arrangement of the possession of the property. Borrower can approach to DRT against possession notice issued under 13 subsection 4 notice. The borrower can approach to DRT within 45 days from the date of receipt of possession notice. He can file to, he can go to DRT file. This is under section 17 of the act. Appeal to DRAT against decision of DRT under section 18, that is 30 days from the order of the DRT, party can approach to debt recovery appellation. Notice before sale, rule number 8, sub rule 6, 30 days. Action notice, rule number 9, sub rule 1, 30 days notice. These are the summary of important sections and time periods for revision purpose. Thank you very much for all, and please subscribe our YouTube channel for JAB and CAB and promotional exam videos also. For further videos, please watch our YouTube channel. Thank you very much for all.